Hello, welcome to today's video. In today's video, we will talk about 8 simple ways to be mentally healthy. We all strive to be mentally healthy, no matter who we are or we are in life. We all want to be happy. We all want to know where we are going and how to control the route. We are comparing ourselves to others. We are analyzing our faults. We obsess over the results. We must learn to be just us. Being mentally healthy is not based on whether or not you are always happy, always productive all the time. Having negative thoughts and feelings are natural and part of being human. Instead, be in good mental health is on healthy coping skills and strategies that you develop for hard times. It's not about who is strong and who is weak. According to NAMI, National Alliance on Mental Illness, 1 to 5 American adults suffer from a mental illness each year. This means that when you are in trouble, you're not alone. But many of us do not feel seen and we grasp the practical tools to be used in those times. If you are mentally healthy, you adapt more to the circumstances, find the good in difficult times, learn to lean on others or seek help when needed, you accept, have a realistic perception, be resilient, and be ready for anything. You live a balanced life knowing what to prioritize. Your self-esteem is high, you are able to communicate your needs, you know your value and you stand for what you love and believe in, giving you a greater sense of meaning and purpose. What this also means to be mentally healthy is that you have a crisis plan for when you do not feel like yourself. This means that you know when you're falling apart, to turn, how to cope and so on. No one is 100% mentally healthy all the time and perfect. If you think otherwise, you're just getting someone's highlight reel or just someone to see you. We stigmatize mental health problems in society, and we use the image to take a false account of what happens to avoid vulnerability. Yet less shame that a person has, the more they will get help. Do not be afraid to talk openly about your feelings. It can be someone you trust, a friend, family member, professional mental health. You are able to handle things in a way that uses healthy coping skills. This could be your interests, your hobbies, journaling, ventilation, someone. You do not let emotions remain bottled lest they explode. Looking for cathartic outputs so you can cope. The symptoms of poor mental health are catastrophism in many ways. Psych Central says that 15 town cognitive distortions are as follows. 1. Filtering. 2. Think polarizing or thinking in black and white. 3. Overgeneralization. 4. Jumping to conclusions. 5. Catastrophizing. 6. Customization. 7. Sophistry control. 8. Equity error. 9. Blaming. 10. Shoulds. 11. Emotional reasoning. 12. The error change. 13. Global labeling. 14. Always be right. 15. Heaven's reward fallacy. For example, jumping to conclusions may mean thinking you know the outcome before it occurs or to have all the facts. Similarly, catastrophism, considering the worst-case scenarios and think only about them happening to you. What they all have in common is that there is a distortion level of thought that can be evaluated and corrected to be more mentally healthy. Generally, you can underestimate the property to you and the tools you have. You have a distorted view of how things will turn out. Thoughts have power. But you can take control today. For further consideration of these distortions with descriptions, see of Psych Central. So how to be mentally healthy? There are 8 simple ways to be in good mental health. How to stay mentally healthy is to use the right tools and as the ancient Greek aphorism, know thyself. 1. Cognitive behavioral therapy. How to be in good mental health begins with cognitive behavioral therapy, or for example the recording of your thoughts to assess whether there are unnecessary compared helpful. It is an easy tool called Carol Vivian Thought Sheet which can be downloaded from here. This registration form describes a situation that has happened, assess your emotion, note the physical sensations, recording useless thoughts, images and alternative list or realistic thoughts to a more balanced perspective and have you find solutions. Ultimately, you reevaluate your feelings. One such tool is effective because it has you stop and analyze a thought rather than ruminate on it, so many of us. It prevents us from the doom and thought in the most adverse scenarios. 2. A maintenance plan for mental health. Another tool called the maintenance plan for mental health comes from the help and therapy can be downloaded here. In this worksheet, you can identify the triggers and warning signs of declining mental health. Taking care of yourself and adaptation strategies are displayed next to help you find a plan for when you are feeling down. He also asked to assess whether you need to seek professional help for these struggles. This is a good tool to practice because it helps you take control of your coping strategies for mental health. When you have a plan in place, you are more likely to act to help your mental status. It is also something that you can share with a therapist to defend their rights and ask for help. You can update it at any time and see your growth. 3. Screen yourself for a mental health problem. Free screening tools for mental health problems, Anxiety Association and the American Depression can be found here. On this site, you can track your anxiety disorders, depression, obsessive compulsive disorder, post-traumatic stress or phobia. You can easily download and share the results with anyone. Nothing is recorded and kept on file about you on the site. ADAA offers not only direct services with mental health problems such as psychiatry or therapy, but provides resources to help. Online psychology assessment is another way to screen for mental health problems with resources to help with them for free. 4. There's an app for that. You can use the lists that can MindWise ROSC help you manage your mental health. App download and try. Some include applications to reduce stress, maintain a mood disorder or improve mood. There are many tools on the internet to help you calm when you are in trouble. The answers are literally at hand. All you have to do is search the web if you do not find what you want. Type a search engine meditations and many come. This is a great way to remind yourself that you have the power or control to help you. Come with a daily routine where you put this into practice. 5. Find a therapist. You can use psychology to find free today's live therapist tool here. If you do not want a live therapist, BetterHelp is another tool to be paired with a therapist, but it is online. Registration for the therapy does not mean that you are weak or unable to handle your problems. This means that you are pretty sure you ask for help when you need it. Professional help does not mean you necessarily have a mental illness. Sometimes we all experienced someone who needs to help us to navigate life. It is very healthy to reach a professional in times of crisis, but also in times of stability. This is because when you navigate life with a mentor, you can recognize the flaws in your thinking. There is much to gain. All you have to do is reach out. 6. Stop the stigma. In you and in society, there is a stigma against mental health problems. If you suffer, speak, alleviate this suffering. Most of us experience fear, the judgment of others. But owning your story and journey in mental health, you can eliminate this fear. Rather than hide your life story and struggles, someone who sees your own strength through it all. Rather than remaining a victim, you become someone who knows what you're worth, scars and all. You prosper then. If someone cannot accept your way of life, it's their loss, not yours. Once you get into that mindset, you can free yourself from the need control over the reactions of others to you. When you stop the stigma, you do good for others to speak their truth too. When you give this acceptance, you also learn to accept you. Here's how you conquer your history of mental health. The story we tell is powerful. This does not mean that you set for the fight, but it means that you do not hide it. Get good mental health is not keeping up with appearances. It is to be yourself and knowing that you do not have to face life alone. 7. Direct action. Giving is receiving. When you get the right help and are at the right level of confidence, you can more easily help others. People need to know they are worth. At all levels of mental health care, a person still has some insecurities. When you give to another person, whether through friendship, volunteering, mentoring, or more, you show that you value that person. It makes you also feel good too. One thing you have to watch for is codependency. Well, or as well be someone else to ignite your own. You cannot help others if you drown too. You have to get on solid before you can be a good option land for people to seek to. When you give to others, you express interest in human interaction, social well and overall humanity that elevates your prospect to feel more focused. When you are late, you can get much more. Simply give your time and attention to someone else that you were perhaps once like. Someone needs help. When you discover the tools to be in good mental health, transmit. This way, you can do good by moving up to your potential as well. Use your goal for pain. It should not be at this moment, right now or even in the near future. Use it to raise you more inspiration to want to lead others someday. 8. Imperfect embrace the process. When you recognize that the process is not perfect, you are more likely to forgive your faults and find meaning in the struggle. You finally decide your reactions, your attitude, your mindset. No amount of therapy or tools you can choose who you want to be. They can guide you in that direction. It is up to you. You are able to handle things in life when you know who you want to be. Have goals, a plan, priorities in place are just as important as learning emotional regulation. Emotional regulation will help you when you start to deal with the cognitive distortions that we all suffer from. You will still experience negative emotions from time to time, and it is a continuous process of learning to cope. Circumstances may sometimes slip our control, but if we have resources, a support system, professional help to turn, adaptability, healthy relationships and purpose, we can begin to regain a sense of optimism even when this occurs. It is normal to have defects. It is normal to fall apart. It is normal to be honest with ourselves and others. What matters is that you do not stop there. You continue. You will rise again. You decide not to let you define. What you do is up to you, but there are tools out there to help shape your destiny. Final thoughts. Being healthy does not mind means you have all the answers. That means you know who you are and what you want out of life. We will all experience conflicts. But your answer is you, no matter what tools you can use. You are able to increase when you have the right help. So do not be afraid to ask. Reach when you feel that you need and check with others, even when things are going well. This habit will make you understand yourself better and grow more. Overall, being in good mental health does not mean that you will not hurt. We all maintenance the needs of mental health, and that is something that can be ignored or kept. When you develop a strong mental attitude, not to mention others along the way who helped you get there. A better world. Giving back. Repeat as many times as necessary. And do not be afraid to be you. Good luck. Please do not forget to subscribe to our channel for more tips on health, relationships, lifestyle, and other useful information to make your life easier.